Okay, hi, I'm Pradeep. I work for a bank. We have a few things. So as Vedat said, there's going to be a quick introduction on what databases we support with Julia. So it's going to be great way. So basically here, there's a list of supported databases. So if you see, Julia supports majority of the databases, so you can see relational databases, you can see NoSQL, and then you can see even in-memory databases. There are some more things, but the top ones here. Okay. But the key point here is that it supports a variety of databases. So what we have done is we have picked some of the DB drivers. Okay, so basically if you see here the MySQL driver, that can work with MySQL. And if you see ODBC or the JDBC driver, it can work with the majority of the databases, which you will see shortly. Okay. And then the interesting thing is with the JDBC driver that is available, you can also connect to Apache HBase through the Apache Phoenix SQL layer, and then there's support for Postgres. So basically this is the feature-wise comparison. So of course basic insert topic, connectors of course everything. So this also talks about the various other features each of these driver provides. For example, the prepare statement is there most of them. Okay. Then support for multi-queries, the native MySQL driver, support for binary JSON. And then confirms to DBA protocol. So basically one of the ideas here is to have a kind of common interface layer so that we have the same kind of interfaces for all the databases. You will see that later why I'm saying this. Then there is support for block syntax, and then the supported package. So if you see, as I said before, for the ODBC and the JDBC drivers, it sort of more or less it can connect to any kind of packet. Okay. So we did some kind of benchmarking. It's not a big one. We are actually going for millions of records, and that is still in progress. Unfortunately, we could not get that into the same time. Okay, but that is something that we are doing so that we sort of. But at least I can tell you upfront that it is looking good on the millions of records. So if you see, most of the drivers here are sort of pretty comparable in terms of their performance. They are doing pretty good. Okay, so this is the same thing that I was supplying the graph that I showed before. Okay, so if you want to see how you can actually connect to a database, it's very simple. In most cases, it is just 2, 3, or 4 lines of code. So in the MySQL thing, you just have to connect with your basic connection parameters and then just call out execute query as simple as that. Of course, MySQL also supports prepare statement. So in which case, probably another one more line of code. So with Postgres again, it's just 4 lines. So it's as simple as this. Okay, that's the thing. And if you notice here, one of the things I said earlier was to have some kind of a common interface layer. If you see here, you can see there is a difference in the interfaces here. So that's one thing that we are working on, and probably will have a common interface across the databases. Okay. So in which way, so what that means is that you will be able to switch between databases very easily, okay, without having to change any of your code.
is returning data frames, right? The right hand side, both of them.
Sorry?
Are they returning data frames?
Yes. In fact, yeah. All of them, these are all done. In fact, all of them are returning data frames. Okay, in terms of roadmap, as I said, you know, we want to have a common interface layer across all the databases and support for blobs. Then of course we have similar support for NoSQL. I mean, we do have support for, you know, you saw in the earlier list that we do support MongoDB and what we have, but we there also we would probably want to have a, you know, some kind of a common interface layer there as well. And probably we'll also add more databases into the list. Okay, and also, of course, the other thing which I have not mentioned here is probably we will also do this kind of benchmarking for all the databases and publish that, so that, you know, before any of you use, you have some idea of what you are getting. And of course, needless to say, we need more and more contributors. So any of you wanting to help, you're always welcome. Okay. That's a short introduction on the databases. So,
any questions?
Any questions?
So, with the common interface, is it a design document which can be accessed? Because so we know that R has this library DBI, for example, which is sort of a common interface for accessing any kind of relational database, and coded in it.
So in fact, there is a DBI package even in Julia, but unfortunately, I have to admit that not all the drivers actually conform to that. So that's
future work. I mean,
that's exactly what we
want. Okay, we want to get there
short
as soon as we can. But
we're
not there yet.
Yeah, but there is a package, but of course, we don't conform to all. Not all the packages will conform to that. So that's where we want to get.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thanks, everyone.